With me again is economics professor Dr. Tom Smythe from Furman University. If I'm a business owner, and this week, as the days go by, what am I thinking?
What are the rules going to look like after Thursday? Really, the thing that we've struggled with for the last 2.5 or 3 years, really since 2011, is we still haven't come to grips with the underlying problems that we're facing as a result of the debt ceiling debate. Again, that decision is relatively benign, but the spending issues and whether we're going to pay our bills are substantive issues. And if I'm a business owner and we still don't come up with solutions to try to address the fundamental underlying problems, I'm going to continue to hold back. I'm not going to hire. I'm not going to spend money. I'm not going to invest.
So in a way, this and the sequester and all this other uncertainty is why the state's unemployment rate is still as high as it is?
Absolutely. You hit the nail on the head, Nigel. The issue here is uncertainty. And it's uncertainty for business owners, but it's uncertainty for folks like us as well. We don't know what's going to happen. So by definition, we're going to tend to sort of hold back with spending and things of that mm-hmm. nature, because we're not sure if we're going to be in a situation like in 2008.
And what's scary, too, for so many people, their pot of gold is their 401k.
Absolutely.
Will this affect that? It's money in the bank.
Certainly in the short term, with the volatility that would come about in the marketplace, there would be issues. But if I could tell people anything, is that investing in a 401k is a marathon, not a sprint. Mm. Look at, you know, the next 20, 30 years. The reality is there's not a whole lot you can do right now between now and Thursday that's going to make a huge effect. But look over the long term. Investing for retirement is a long-term process.
And real quick, so when we talk debt ceiling, we're talking about, and correct me if I'm wrong, kind of like we've given out IOUs correct. And a promise to pay you back. Mm-hmm. Now, if we do hit this debt ceiling and we can't pay people back, people aren't going to, countries, organizations aren't going to forget that.
Yeah, ironically, we seem to be caught up sort of as a culture about the United States being a superpower and a major player. If we don't pass a debt ceiling, superpower status is gone. The reality is every other time we've seen a change in sort of the fundamentals of the economy and who becomes the major players, it's always been a transition approach. Wow. In the marketplace. This wouldn't be a transition. This would be an instant credibility check that people would question for a long time.
We will see what happens. Dr. Tom Smythe of Furman University, thank you very much.
Thank you.